When we're drawing straight lines, it's very important to hold your pencil nice and loose, and we don't want a floppy wrist. If you have a floppy wrist, you're just going to draw curved lines. So we want to have our wrist in a nice neutral position. We want to lock our elbow, and we want to move from the shoulder, and we want to move in a decisive way. And that will give us much more straight lines. Practice going in various angles. You should be able to make straight lines in many angles. So just go ahead and fill up your page with lots of straight lines, trying to go in any angle. Try some pulling towards you. You should be able to fill up the entire page with lots and lots of straight lines. Remember, keep your wrists still, your elbows still, and move from the shoulder. Once you can draw random straight lines on the page, now we need to be able to draw straight lines in between two points. So put a couple dots on the page, and then put your pencil on the first, and then move your arm with the pencil in the air until you think that you're going to hit that mark, and then draw your line. Try it again. Start on the one side, and then draw your mark. You want to move quickly and decisively. Don't chicken scratch across the page, even if that is straight. Another exercise we can do is we can make an arc and then put a dot, and then we can start at one line. And then we can continue to do this. Keep putting dots at different parts on your page and then trying to connect them. Make the dots farther and farther apart. If you mess up, just do it again. Remember, this is not about making art. This is about getting more hand control. These are exercises and drills. So continue practicing this until you have a full page of dots and lines. Once we're able to hit from one dot to another point, we want to start practicing drawing parallel lines, and we want to draw long lines. So go ahead and put your paper horizontal, and what we want to do is try to draw all the way across. And just keep making parallel lines. Some of them will be wavy, but you want to make them as straight as you can. Just keep doing them. It's a good idea to look at your target rather than your pencil. So look to where you are going. Now, this is a freehand line, so it'll never be perfectly straight, but the more you practice, the straighter your lines will be. Go ahead and flip the page and then start drawing lines across. Each one is a new opportunity to draw that perfect straight line. Again, if you mess up, then just draw one more straight one. The more you do this, the straighter your lines will be, and the more confident you will be in your sketching. The important thing here is that you're able to draw parallel lines. Once you've done that, we also want to try to draw them at an angle. At this point, it's good to practice keeping your hand off the page, because there's many times like this that your page will be filled with sketches and you want to be able to not smudge them as you're going down. These diagonal ones are really long, so make sure you pay attention and practice those well. This is a good exercise because it has both long lines and short lines, so you have to have different types of muscle control. And once we've completed that way, we want to go ahead and do the final one. And if you look back, some of your lines will be straighter than other lines, but this is a perfectly good enough for making technical drawings and ideating your sketches. So, and this is also a great warm-up to do before you start isometric sketching or other technical drawing. You don't have to make a grid like this, but spend a minute or two just making some lines, and then your arm and hand will be warmed up, and you're ready to make all your wonderful ideas come alive on the page.